Hello, and thank you for installing UltraWideo extension. You'll be greeted with this onboarding tutorial. But if you don't want to read it or you're just preferring to watch a video, you can do it here. It will be hosted on YouTube and I'll use the comment section to split it into sections so you can skip easily between the things that you don't care about because you're probably using a single browser on your machine. And in this video, I will show you what's needed for each browser or where to find keyboard configuration in each browser, etc. So to begin with, we'll go with Firefox because there's one additional step that Firefox users need to do after the installation. So click on the puzzle icon, go to gear icon, click on manage extension, go to permissions, and make sure that this option is toggled on so the extension has access to all your websites. You can go back now. Actually, you can, from this screen, you can click on the gear, go to manage extension shortcuts. And in this page, you can configure the shortcuts if you don't like the built-in ones or they do not function for some reason. Close that. We can switch to another browser. Let's go to Chrome. And same thing, you go to puzzle, three dots, manage extension. Here you can find the shortcuts configuration panel, and if you want to make sure that you have access, that the extension has access to all websites, you can do it here. But all Chromium based browsers come with this option enabled by default. In case they ever change it in the future, this is where to look at. Now we can just go quickly through all other browsers because they're very similar to Chrome. So let's go to Brave, puzzle, menu, manage extensions. It has access to all websites. Keyboard shortcuts are right here. You can go to the next one. Let's go Opera, box instead of the puzzle, three dots, manage extension. It has access to all websites. Go to keyboard shortcuts. You can tweak them here. Close that. Go to the arc. Now this one's different, so go here. In this little settings icon in the URL, go to three dots, manage extensions, go to details of the UltraWideo. We make sure it has access to all websites, go to keyboard shortcuts, find UltraWideo, you can configure them here. And finally, go to the edge, puzzle icon, three dots, manage extension. It has access to all websites and keyboard shortcuts in the side panel. So as you can see, they're very similar to Chrome, exception to the Firefox users. And now I can just go back to Chrome and I can show you how it works in action on YouTube, for example. So I'm not sure I can use this video. Let's just go to, I remember something like this, yeah. So I use this video in the interactive tutorial, and I'm going to use it here to show you how it works in action. So go to full screen, and I can press on Mac Command Shift Z to toggle between modes. I can press Command Shift X to pause the extension. So now changing the mode will do nothing, but if I leave it on the upscale and click to unpause the activity, it will automatically apply the mode that's previously activated in the background. And it's like this on all the browsers, but there's one hidden feature that I want to also share because it's kind of impossible to do it in the written form. So if you are on touchscreen, you can touch your screen, pinch it inside to change the mode, or pinch it like outwards, inwards and outwards, I think that's the better word, to change the modes like before or after, or you can just keep pinching inside and it will just keep cycling through the modes. Aside, if you're on the laptop that has a trackpad, of course, but supports multi-gestures like MacBooks, I think all of the modern laptops actually do, you can also pinch your trackpad to do to achieve the same effect that you would on the touchscreen. And lastly, if you have a desktop PC or you use a laptop with a mouse, you can press Control and you can scroll up to change the modes or down if you want to go the other way around. So that's like one nifty hidden feature that you all will probably use a lot instead of the shortcut. And also I will show you all of the other shortcuts that are built in. So I can press Control Command period on Mac to toggle the interface, or you can just go here and pin it for easier access. And you can use the Shift Z and Shift Command Shift Z and Command Shift X to either toggle activity or mode that I already showed you. And the only thing that does not have a shortcut built in is the scale feature, because there's a limitation in a browser how many shortcuts can one extension have. So if I go to the full screen and I just cannot access the extension anymore, so instead I can use the shortcut to toggle the interface, and in this case I can just change to stretch, for example. And then if I do not want it stretch, I can probably adjust the scaling point a little bit, as you can see, or I can maybe reveal some black bars if I want to see some content, but I don't want the image distorted and I don't really care about some black bars, then I can probably tweak it around here. And it works simultaneously with the currently active mode. So if I leave those at 0.9 and 0.8 and go to upscale, you can see that it didn't fill my entire screen. But if I restore this to initial values, which is 1, it will actually take entire screen. This was a highly requested feature from previous users, because some of them wanted to preserve content but still remove some of the black bars. So that's like a little bit of more sort of advanced feature that I don't think everybody will use, but it's there if you need it. And so that's pretty much it for this video tutorial. Hope it clarified many things or questions you may have asked. Otherwise, if you have a spare minute, please leave a review if this extension is useful to you. And I'll see you in the next one.